الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على حبيبنا الكريم شفيعنا قرة أعيننا نور قلوبنا سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد فيا عباد الله اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون Blessed congregation, ladies and my dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us to always have taqwa in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Taqwa, which means to fulfill our obligations towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Taqwa means to stay away from all the prohibitions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and conduct ourselves in the best of manners, as was taught to us by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah give us the strength to act upon what Allah has taught us. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. For the past weeks, the sermons have taught us or reminded us on the importance of having religious knowledge. And we were also reminded about the importance of understanding the Quran and getting the correct interpretations of the Quran. And that is part of seeking knowledge, which is an obligation for us. And not only that, knowledge makes us become to have a high status in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentions in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يرفع الله الذين آمنوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات والله بما تعملون خبير. Which means Allah will raise the ranks of those who believe from amongst you, and also for those who were given knowledge, Allah raised them many degrees and many ranks, and Allah is aware always of whatever that you do. This verse reminds us on the importance of knowledge, and also mentions that someone who is knowledgeable, but we have to realize that what is meant by knowledge here that raises us in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is knowledge that is beneficial, knowledge that brings us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowledge that makes us realize the objective of our existence is to know and come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the only thing that causes our ranks to rise in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so in the pursuit of knowledge, we need to ensure that our obligations or our other obligations are not forsaken. All of these have to improve or move in tandem so as to achieve success in this world and also in the hereafter. As was said by Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah, "Man arada ad-dunya fa'alayhi bil-'ilm, wa man arada al-akhirah fa'alayhi bil-'ilm, wa man arada huma ma'an fa'alayhi bil-'ilm." Which means, for those who aspire for the dunya, he has, or it requires for him to have knowledge. And for those who aspire to have success in akhirah, he has to have knowledge. And for those who wants both dunya and akhirah, it also requires him to have the necessary knowledge. This advice bears important learning points, not only for us, but for us who are parents or educators in providing for our children, or in the pursuit of providing the best education for our children. We always, or most of us, always aim to have the best education for our children. Usually, or most of us also spare no costs in paying for the best education that our children can get, so that they have the best opportunity to have success in the future. In doing this, we must also not forget our obligation to teach them, or to make sure that they get the necessary education, not only to succeed in this life, but also to succeed in akhirah, in the hereafter, in yawmil qiyamah, so that all of us can be in the paradise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So both of the education that brings us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and other types of education should also be something that brings us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Both of it is important in any field of education. As long as our children are given education, or proper education, with that, we are supposed to be able to safeguard our children from negative influences. For example, children who are not in school, they are more prone to be influenced by negative influences out there. And also, findings have documented that parental negligence, especially on children's education, is one of the major causes of juvenile delinquency. It would be most unfortunate that the affected children will gradually lose interest in their studies and turn their attention to a way of life which eventually leads them towards criminal activities. May Allah protect our children from this harm. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu was quoted to say, which means, teach your children, educate your children differently from the education that you received in your young life. For Allah has made them to face the challenges of their times and not the challenges of your time. So in comprehending the wise words of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, we perceive that every generation has its own set of challenges, and our acquired knowledge that we have gotten in our time serves us well in overcoming the challenges that we have faced in our lives. Similarly, our children are expected to be equipped with the necessary knowledge for their challenges that they will face in the future. The future requires them to have sets of skills and competencies which they need to acquire when they are in this young age. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon us and our children the love for knowledge, all types of knowledge that brings us success in the world and also in the hereafter. And may Allah give our children the love for knowledge that brings us closer to Allah. And may Allah instill in the hearts of our children love for the people of knowledge, the ulama and the salihin and their teachers. May Allah continue to protect us and guide us in our endeavor to strengthen our faith. And may we be saved from the worldly tests that will lead us to our destruction. May Allah shower upon us the blessings of this month of Sha'ban and upcoming night of Nisfu Sha'ban. And through it too, we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy and protection for our beloved Muslim brothers and sisters, wherever they may be, especially our brothers in Syria, in Rohingya, in Palestine. May Allah protect them and keep them safe and give them the best of rewards and elevate their rank. thanks. Amin. Ya Rabbal Alameen. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'anil Azim. Wa nafa'ani wa iyaakum bima fihi min al-ayati wa dhikri al-hakim. Wa taqabbala minni wa minkum tilawatahu innahu huwa as-sami'ul alim. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah al-azim li wa lakum. Wa li sa'iril muslimina wal muslimat. Wal mu'minina wal mu'minat. فاستغفروه فيا فوز المستغفرين ويا نجاة التائبين
آمين يا موفق طاعين وفقنا لتعدك أجمعين وتب علينا واغفر ذنب من يقول استغفر الله العظيم استغفر الله
الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على حبيبنا المصطفى سيدنا محمدٍ وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد فيا عباد الله اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون My dear brothers, always have taqwa in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember that life is short. And we can be called by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without notice. That is why we are always reminded to have taqwa in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if we were to be called at any time, we would be ready to face the questions asked upon us. By always maintaining ourselves in the state of having taqwa in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first khutbah stressed the importance of education. And its positive effects on our children and that it safeguards our children from harm and negative influences. Islam also places much emphasis on the preservation of intellect, health, and faith. These are also the principles which explain why Islam prohibits the consumption of alcohol. And on a higher level of harm, Islam also prohibits the consumption of drugs. When one associates oneself with drugs, one does not only cause harm to himself, but the wellness of his family is also threatened as a result of his drug abuse. Maybe many of us will feel like this is something that we are not affected by these things. But in reality, there are a lot of people around us, maybe people we know, maybe even our friends, maybe even our family members are afflicted by this situation or have an addiction on drugs. Not only the hardcore drugs that we usually hear about, but statistics show that more and more from our community are addicted with recreational drugs that they take, seemingly thinking that recreational drugs are not harmless, but instead it brings the same negative consequences of any type of drugs that causes harm to us. So we must enforce this holistic type of education in not only teaching our children about success in this world, about passing of examinations, but the purpose of education is to raise our status as human beings, to become people who give benefit to mankind, to bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the objective of education, not only to seek good paying jobs, but how to bring benefit to people and how to answer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the knowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon us. And also, relating to the topic that we have just said, we too should offer our help to support individuals who are undergoing rehabilitation from addiction from drugs so as to prevent them from falling into the same mistake and with earnest hopes that they will one day be able to kick off their addiction and contribute to society. Amin ya Rabbil Alameen. Ala sallu sallimu ala Nabi al-Mustafa khayril anam. Haythu qala Allah ta'ala fi kitabih. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. ورضى اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين سادتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي رضي الله عنهم وعن بقية الصحابة والقرابة والتابعين وتابع التابعين وتابعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا ولوالدينا وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا. واغفر لأساتذتنا ولمشايخنا ولمعلمينا أجمعين. Ya Allah, ya Tuhan kami, ampunkanlah segala dosa dan keterlanjuran kami. Ya Allah, ya Tuhan kami, ampunkanlah segala dosa kedua orang tua kami. Ya Allah, rahmatilah mereka seperti mana mereka membesarkan kami dengan penuh rahmat dan kasih sayang. Ya Allah, ampunkanlah segala dosa setiap daripada guru-guru yang telah membimbing kami. Ya Allah, ya Tuhan kami, kurniakanlah kepada kami kebaikan dunia dan akhirat. Berilah keringanan kepada saudara dan saudari kami yang dizalimi di mana sahaja mereka berada. Ya Allah, berilah bantuan dan pertolongan dan kemenangan kepada mereka. Ya Allah, ya Tuhan kami. Ibadallah, innallaha ya'muru bil 'adli wal ihsan wa ita'i dzil qurba wa yanha 'anil fahsya'i wal munkari wal baghi ya'idukum la'allakum tadhakkarun. Fadhkurullaha al-'azima yadhkurkum washkuruhu 'ala ni'amihi yazidkum was'aluhu min fadlihi yu'tikum wa ladhikrullahi akbar wallahu ya'lamu ma tasna'un.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا
سووا صفوفكم فإن تسوية الصف من إقامة الصلاة. Rapatkan dan luruskan barisan kerana ia sebahagian daripada kesempurnaan solat. Straighten our rows, make sure our heels are on the same line. Tarasu atadilu yarhamni warhamkumullah. Allahu akbar.
Allahu akbar.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لا
في الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا ولك الحمد.
الله أكبر
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 الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا ولك الحمد.
الله أكبر
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 الله أكبر.
السلام عليك أيها النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليك وعلى آله وصحبه أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
أستغفر الله العظيم أستغفر الله العظيم أستغفر الله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه
اللهم أنت السلام منك السلام إليك يا عبد السلام فحينا ربنا بالسلام وادخلنا الجنة دار السلام تبارك ربنا وتعالى انت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام اللهم لا مانع لما أعطيت ولا معطي لما منعت ولا راد لما قضيت ولا ينفع ذا الجد منك الجد اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك يا مقلب القلوب والأبصار ثبت قلوبنا على دينك وعلى طاعتك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وإلهكم إله واحد لا إله إلا هو الرحمن الرحيم الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم وإن من شيء لا يشبه بحمده سبحان الله. الحمد لله. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر كبيرا، الحمد لله كثيرا، سبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا، لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم استغفر الله العظيم. Dear brothers, let us together recite Surah Al-Fatiha. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with that gives safety for Haji Hurairah, Haji Muhammad Taha and shower his blessings upon Ghazala Saudari Dayang Haji Zaitun binti Haji Muhammad Noor, Haji Burhanuddin Hassan, Shahrizan bin Ahmad. And may Allah forgive the sins and elevate the ranks of Al-Marhum Ja'far bin Ahmad, Al-Marhumah Datin Hajah Nur Ashikin Abdullah, Al-Marhumah Hajah Lili Wazna Bukhair. Alayni al-Qabool wa ila ahlatul Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam al-Fatiha. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. 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 Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Allahumma anta rabbi la ilaha illa anta alayka tawakkaltu wa anta rabbul arshil azim ma syaa Allahu kana wa ma lam yasyaa lam yakun wa la haula wa la quwwata illa billahil aliyyil azim a'lamu anna Allah 'ala kulli syai'in khadir wa 'ala Allah qad hatta bi kulli syai'in 'ilma Allahumma inna a'udzu bika min syarri nafsi wa min syarri kulli dhabatin 'anta akhdhu min nasiyatiha inna rabbi 'ala siratin mustaqim rabbana taqabbal minna du'ana innaka tusami'ul 'alim wa tub 'alaina innaka tatawwabur rahim wa la tu'akhidhna bil 'azami wal jarami ya karim dawahum fiha subhanak Allahumma wa tahiyyatuhum fiha salam wa akhiru dawana alhamdulillahi rabbil 'alamin taqabbal Allahu minkum.